vessel that God can't mend. And when the whole world turned their backs on you, He will be your friend. One broken vessel that God can't mend. For there's not one broken vessel that God cannot mend. And when the whole world turns on you, He will be your friend. He'll pick up your pieces time and time again. For there is not one broken vessel cannot mend. Jesus is a potter, you and I just a little clay. And even when a vessel gets broken, He never throw the clay away, but He pick up our pieces time and time again. For there is not one broken vessel that God cannot. There is not one broken vessel.
Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Yes, my friend, there is just not one broken vessel that God cannot mend. Praise God. Greetings, greetings in the wonderful and precious name of Jesus. Praise the Lord, glory be to God. I want to ask you to get on and just start sharing with all your friends and let them know that I'm on. Praise the Lord, share in your groups. Praise God, I'm coming with a teaching, praise God. We got to be looking at the rapture. We got to be looking at the rapture. You know, that is something that several persons has been asking me to share on, praise God. And so, praise the Lord, we're going to be looking at the rapture, praise the Lord. So, go ahead and start sharing with your friends, praise the Lord. I'm going to be right back. I'm going to start this one from the top, praise the Lord. Taking it back from the top for you. There is not one broken vessel that God can't mend. Stay tuned.
The thief was down to his last breath, hanging there on Calvary. When he turned to the Master, say, Lord, have mercy on me. He was just a broken vessel till Jesus washed his sins all away. For there is not one broken that God can't mend. There's not one broken vessel vessel that God can't mend. And when the whole world turn their backs on you, He will be your friend.
Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Yes, praise God. I want to send a special shout out to all of you out there. Praise the Lord. God bless you. That's right. Go ahead and send up your praise. Praise the Lord. Come on in if you're on the outside looking in. Praise the Lord. Glory be to God. Come on in so I can acknowledge you. Praise the Lord. So I'd love to call your name. Praise God. If you're a minister of the gospel, if you're a pastor, evangelist, my brethren, praise the Lord. God bless you. Hey, man of God. Praise God, Minister Luther Barnes. God bless you, Cheryl, out there in Canada. Praise the Lord. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Come on in, guys. Praise the Lord. God bless you, Bishop Leroy. Praise the Lord. Julianne Alexander, Cora. Praise God. Hallelujah. Yes, praise the Lord. Glory be to God. Come on in and just, you know, leave a comment. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. It's going to be awesome. Praise God. I'm going to be doing some teaching. We're going to get in the Word of God. Praise God. I'm going to be looking at the rapture. It's a topic that is hard. Let's talk. I've spoken of today. Praise God. When it comes to end time prophecy, praise the Lord. You know, I'm a woman that is deep into end time prophecy, into Revelation, into Daniel. Praise the Lord. Glory be to God. The book of Daniel, that is. Praise God. And so the Lord is really, 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 really laid it in my heart for us to look. Let's go back. You know, in the olden days, you know, we heard a lot about the rapture. We heard about the coming of the Lord. And even though it's been so long, there's a lot of people who don't believe that Jesus is about to return. But I know that He's coming back again. Praise God. Stay tuned. I'm going to be right back, sharing your groups with your friends, your family members, your co-workers. Praise the Lord. Going to be right back. God bless you, Winston. Praise the Lord. God bless you. Thanks for coming on. God bless you. Thanks for coming on.
Again, for there is not one broken vessel that God cannot mend. There is not one broken vessel that God cannot mend. And when the whole world turned their backs on you, He will be your friend.
Oh Jesus, oh Jesus.
Somebody want to worship. Pick up your pieces.
Somebody want to worship. Somebody want to worship.
Time and time again.
Praise the Lord.
For there is not one broken vessel that God can't mend.
Praise the Lord. And because we know there is not one broken vessel that God can't mend, praise the Lord, that's why we got to make sure that our anchor holds. Praise the Lord. No matter what its storm clouds are raging, no matter what storm clouds are raging, no matter what they're doing to you, talking about you, trying to take you out, take you down, make sure that you know that your anchor still holds. Praise God. And that you're rooted and grounded in the Lord. Praise God. We got to be looking at the rapture. We got to be looking at the rapture. Praise God. The second advent. Praise the Lord. I believe that this is the time and the season. Praise God. Where we want to delve in to end time prophecy. Praise the Lord. Come on in, guys. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Jesus.
The anchor holds.
know, sometimes, praise God, our sails are torn. Sometimes we go through so much, you know, the trials, the struggles. It causes our sails to be torn in different ways from time to time. Each and every one of us have a season where we go through some torn sails. Praise God. But glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus. It's good to know that your anchor holds. God bless you. Sister Angela, Janet, Sister Janet, God bless you. Praise God. Thanks for your shares, guys. Thanks for sharing in your groups and with your family members, with your friends. Praise God. Your spouses, praise God. Your spouse, rather. Your children, praise the Lord. We're going to be looking at a powerful topic, the rapture. Praise the Lord. We're going to delve into the Word of God in a few minutes. Praise the Lord. As the Lord leads, praise the Lord. Glory be to God. Come on, if you're on the outside looking in, praise God. If you're on the outside looking on, come on inside. We're together in this. Amen. Glory be to God. We're going to get in the Word of God. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
The anchor holds, though my ship is battered. The anchor holds.
Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Hallelujah. Heavenly Father, Almighty God, right now in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I pray, oh God, that the anointing, oh God, will flow out of this studio, right into homes, right into bedrooms, Father God. I pray, oh God, that it'll flow into hospital rooms, Father, airports. Praise God. You know, business places, taxi stands. Because of the different time zones, oh God, I pray, oh God, that somebody somewhere will be blessed, oh God, by this word. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. God bless you, Umba. God bless you. God bless you wherever you are. Africa, praise God. United Kingdom, UK, America, praise God. Canada, praise the Lord. Barbados, Trinidad and Tobago, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Wherever you are, Cayman Islands, Jamaica, wherever you are, I don't know where you are, but the Holy Spirit knows where you are. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. There is something about Jesus. There is something about my life since I met the man called Jesus. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. There is something since I met Jesus. Hallelujah. I'm singing a new song, guys. Praise God. Hallelujah. Giving you some music and I'm coming into the word. The rapture.
Since I met you, Jesus, my whole life has changed.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God.
Everybody tells me that I'm not the same.
I'm not the same. Oh, can somebody praise him that know what I'm talking about? Can somebody praise him?
I don't need nobody.
Oh, Jesus.
To turn my troubles
to. Oh, God. Hallelujah.
I don't need nobody. To tell my troubles too.
Tell them to Jesus. Tell them to Jesus.
Cause since I met you, Jesus, all I need is you.
Oh Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. God, you have been good to me.
Yes, Lord.
God, you have been good, you have been good.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
The struggles are so hard, and the time seems so tough. But God,
somebody want to praise him. Somebody want to praise him. Somebody somewhere want to praise him. Yes, yes, somebody want to praise him.
And the tempest may roll. God, you have been good. You have been good to me. Since I met you, Jesus, I'm a happy girl.
God bless you, Delta. God bless you. Welcome.
Since I met you, Jesus, I'm a happy girl.
gonna try to please you in every way I can.
You know, I just want to encourage someone, praise the Lord. You know, sometimes people want to look at your past. People want to remember where you're coming from. People want to remember all the things you ever did. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. But there's not one broken vessel that God can't mend. And you, praise God, you know that your anchor holds, praise the Lord. And I know that since I met the Lord, that I'm not the same, praise God. And because I know all of these things, praise God, I can ride out my storm, praise God. Let me take this from the top, praise the Lord. I can ride out my storm. Is there anybody that want to testify before I go into the word? Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. This one is for you, my friend.
And it seems like forever. The night of confusion.
Glory to God.
Has been on so long. Your ship has lost anchor. In the storm that you're drifting.
Oh, yes, Lord.
Almost over.
Ride out your storm.
Oh Lord.
Ride out your storm.
Ride out your storm. God is right here with you.
Right here with you.
You may not feel it.
You may not feel it.
Jesus.
You're not alone.
You're not alone.
Your ship has lost anchor.
Ship has lost anchor. You're drifting.
You're not almost over. You're not
glory to God.
Over.
Ride out your storm.
Just remember His promise.
Oh Lord.
He said He'll never leave you. Though the waters are raging, they will do you no harm.
My God.
Don't give up the battle.
Oh,
the morning is coming. Though you're not almost over. You're not almost over. You can ride out your storm. Ride out your storm.
Ride out your storm.
God is right here with you.
Right here with you.
You may not feel it.
You may not feel it.
You're not alone.
Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Jerome, God bless you, son. Praise God, hallelujah. Wendy Karan, praise God. God bless you for your testimony. Praise the Lord, hallelujah. Yes, yes, ride out your storm. Praise God, hallelujah. Praise the Lord. For those of you on the outside looking on, praise God, come on in and just leave a word, leave a comment if you're being blessed. Ride out your storm, praise God. I don't know who's going through a storm right now. I don't know what you're facing. I don't know what the struggles are. I don't know exactly what's happening. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Teresa is asking when I'm coming to Cayman. Praise God. I'm going to soon let you know. Praise God. I want to take this back. Praise the Lord. I want to take that song back. The Holy Spirit just bid me to take that song back for someone. I'm going to get in touch with you, TT. Praise the Lord. God bless you. Praise God. Liz Wall. Praise God. Hallelujah. Come on in. Praise God. Hallelujah. God bless all of you. Praise God. God bless all of you. Praise the Lord. Thanks for your shares, guys. You're being a blessing to others. Praise God. Thanks for forwarding in your groups to your friends and family members and colleagues. Praise God. You just never know. Praise God. You just never know who might need to hear a word or a song. Stay tuned. Gotta be looking at the rapture. Gotta be looking at the rapture. Praise God. Hallelujah. Popular. One of my favorites. Praise God. Remember, you gotta ride out your storm. Remember, God is right there with you. Praise the Lord. The bills might be some mountain. But remember, you're not alone. Praise God. Even though it seems like it. Yes, your ship might have lost some anchor. Yes, and you're drifting. But you're not alone. Ride it out. Ride it out, my friend. Ride out your storm. Sister Janet, praise God. Thanks for that testimony. Never forget you, Bishop. You did so much for my salvation. We give God thanks, and it's all because of the word. Praise the Lord. God bless you. God bless you. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Keep on riding out your storms, guys. Praise God. You're not alone. Praise God. You feel alone. Family forsake you. Maybe your best friends, church brethren, co-workers, praise God, business partners, your husband, your wife, your friend forsake you and ride out your storm. I thank God for Calvary. I don't know about you, my friend, but I thank God for Calvary. Praise the Lord. Is there anyone that want to say, Lord, I thank you. I thank God for Calvary. I thank God for the preaching of the gospel. I thank God for the good old preaching of the gospel.
I took a walk down to the dance floor where I used to dance. I met the same guy that I danced with before. When he asked me for a dance, I just tell him, thanks to Calvary.
Hallelujah.
I don't dance here anymore. Thanks to Calvary, I'm not the girl I used to be. Thank you, Jesus. Thanks to Calvary, things are different than before.
Hallelujah.
Wrong, I just tell him, thanks to Calvary, I don't dance here.
Wow, God
anymore.
Bless you, Tom Davis, praise God, out there in the UK. God bless you, my brother, praise God. God saved this year in March from involvement with the New Age. Oh my God,
Jesus.
Tom, I am so happy for you, my brother. Praise God. What a good God we have. Thank you, Jesus. Somebody praise the Lord. There is a brother who has been delivered from the New Age movement who is now, praise God, spreading the gospel, the good news of Jesus Christ. We were all there, my brother, in some way, somehow, involved in all kind of things. God bless you, my Pastor Brown, out there in Hollywood, Florida, with Vision America Church of God, one of our branches. God bless you. I'm going to take this one back for you, Tom. This one is dedicated to you and your wife, to you and your family, my brother. Praise God. Thanks to Calvary. Somebody want to praise God. Oh, I love the testimonies that are coming in. Praise the Lord. This program is all about the Word of God. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise God. You're not the man you used to be. You're not the guy you used to be. You're not the woman you used to be. We have been changed. Praise God. Testimonies are coming in. Praise the Lord. This one is for you, Tom, my brother. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
for a dance.
Thank you, Jesus.
I just tell him.
Hallelujah. God bless you, Sonia. God bless you, Sonia Blake.
I don't dance there anymore. Thanks to Calvary, I'm not the girl I used to be. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thanks to Calvary, things are different than before. When he asked me what was wrong, I just tell him.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Thanks to Calvary.
You know, that's the good thing, praise God, about Calvary. Praise the Lord. You can't dance the same dance. You can't go to the same places. You don't have that craving. You don't have that desire. Once you're changed, praise God, once you have a visit on Calvary, at Calvary, praise the Lord, you're not the girl you used to be. Hallelujah. Somebody want to praise the Lord. Praise God.
Used to drink. I made some friends that I dreamt with before. When they offered me a drink, I just stared there. Thank you, Jesus.
Lord God.
Thanks to Calvary, I don't drink hair anymore. I'm not the girl I used to be. Oh yes, Lord. Thanks to Calvary, things are different than before. When they offered me a drink, I just tell them. I don't drink hair anymore. Thanks to Calvary, I'm not the girl I used to be. Thank you, Jesus. Thanks to Calvary, things are different than before.
Somebody want to praise. Somebody want to praise.
Asked me what was wrong. I just tell them. Thanks to Calvary, I don't drink hair anymore. Thanks to Calvary, I don't drink hair anymore.
Praise God, praise God, yeah. Praise God. Hallelujah. Yes, my brother. Thanks to Calvary, I don't drink hair anymore. Hallelujah. Around the throne, praise God. Some of your family members might have gone on to glory. Praise God. I'm going to be talking about the rapture. We'll be talking about the rapture, teaching on the rapture in a few minutes. Praise the Lord. Just giving a few more persons time to come on, giving you some time to share, sharing all your groups. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Beautiful music for you. Welcome, welcome to Carib Cool Breeze. And I am Apostle, praise God, Dr. Juliet Fagan, Seeing Bishop Fagan, praise the Lord, Overseer of Vision Miracle Church of God, Evangelistic Association, located right here in beautiful Portmore, St. Catherine, Jamaica, also down there in Denby, Clarendon, Jamaica, praise God, Hollywood, Florida, also overseeing in Sanctuary of Love right there in Orlando, Florida, and many more churches to come. Speaking those things that be not as though they were. But stay tuned.
They don't live here anymore. They are somewhere around the throne. Come on. Somewhere. searching until I shall find them.
They are somewhere around God's throne.
Hallelujah.
The preacher, he was still there
when he met me
at the door. He said, I know who you are, and I know who you're looking for, but they don't come here.
Oh, praise God. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Yes, our family members that have died in Christ, they are somewhere around the throne of God. God bless you. Praise God. Man of God, minister, pastor, praise God, bishop, whatever. Prophesy it. Dream perfect. God bless you on your new launch that's coming up. God is good. Go in faith, my brother. Go in faith. Praise the Lord. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. God bless you. God bless you. Those of you on the outside, Vincent Wilburn. Yes, come on in. Cora Thomas Campbell. Praise God. Marina Christian Connolly. God bless you. Praise the Lord. Dwight O'Garo. Praise God. God bless you, my friend. Yes, Mr. Cadet. Brenda. Yes, my schoolmate. God bless you, my friend. God bless you. God bless you. Praise God. Hallelujah. God bless you. God bless you wherever you are. Praise the Lord. God bless you. Hallelujah. I'm going to be giving you one more song after this. And I don't want you to leave. Praise God. Because this is going to be an uplifting, inspiring word as we look at the rapture. Come on. There's a lot of people go to church. They don't have a clue about the rapture, because it seems as if it's not taught anymore, it's not preached about, you know, it's not something that is relevant anymore to a lot of folks. Praise God. So I'm going to give you one more song, and then I'm going to go into the word for a brief moment, and I'm going to come back with some songs. Amen. It's all about Jesus. Praise God. It's all about Jesus. Praise the Lord. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. I'll be taking it down, changing it for you. Yeah. Pretty interesting. Being wonderfully blessed. Wherever you are, whatever time it is.
Won't stop till I find you. I'm running. Won't stop till I touch you. You're my destination. Lord, you're all I got. Nothing can deter me. I said I won't stop. If it's not you, if it's not you,
worship you. Lord, I love you.
You know, one of the things, praise God, one of the things that I want to make clear, praise God, I would never exchange my salvation for anything. I've been out there. I know what it is to be out there. I know what it is to be drinking and smoking, gallivanting, cursing, fighting. I know what it is to be out there. And I'm telling you, it's over 35 years. It's over 35, almost 36 years since I surrendered my life to the Lord. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And I want to thank God for salvation. I have no regrets. There's a lot of folks that believe that they can't live the Christian life, contrary to what happens at times with the church. Thank you for your prayer. I know somebody's with me. I know somebody's with me. Praise the Lord. Ah, praise God. When you see people praising, you know, we might not be in the same building, but you know, when you see people sending up the praises, praise God, it means that the word, the songs, the word, the exhortations are coming alive. It's alive and well. Praise God. Somebody's praising God. Somebody's worshiping God. One of the things is that a lot of people don't want to say where they're coming from. A lot of people don't want to talk about what they used to do because they think it's going to make them less of a woman or less of a man as a Christian. But I'm telling you, when you can testify about where you're coming from, somebody else might be in the same predicament, the same mess. And because they look at you, and when they look at you and see how God has delivered you and how you're full of joy and happiness and peace, all when all hell is breaking loose, you still have a praise. Even when you have no job, even when the bills are surmounting, you don't know how things will work out, you still know what it is to praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. God bless you, Sir Michael Morgan, out there in the UK. God bless you, Johnny Richards. God bless you. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Cheryl out there in Canada. Praise the Lord. Come on in, guys. Praise God. I'm coming with a word. Praise God. If it's not Jesus, then I don't want it. Hallelujah. Yes, Brother Tom.
It's got to be.
Praise God, praise God, praise God, praise God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God, hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise God. I don't want you to go nowhere. Praise God. I don't want you to go anywhere. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I just want you to stay where you are. Nobody moves. Nobody moves. This is going to be the word. This is going to put the icing on the cake. Praise the Lord. I believe if there was ever a time, praise God. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Praise God. Somebody's encouraging me. Somebody's here encouraging me. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Iron sharpness, iron. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. If there was ever a time that we need the Lord, it is now. Praise the Lord. If there was ever a time that we need the Lord, it is now, brothers and sisters, ladies and gentlemen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. God bless you. God bless you. Bishop R. Simmons. Yes, the man himself. Praise the Lord. God bless you. Want to thank God for the awesome work that you're doing out there in Canada. You and Pastor Simmons, your beautiful wife, your daughter, the team there. Praise God. One of these days, I'm hoping to be there, sir. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Thank God for you. You're doing a mighty work out there in Canada. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. I want to look at the rapture. Praise God. But before I look at the rapture, praise God, I am just going to give you something that I want you to listen to. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. You know, we want to look at the ram's horn. Praise God. It was the ram's horn that was blown. Praise God. Back in the time of Israel, there were different sounds for the ram's horn. Praise God. There were times when it would be sounded to put the people on guard, to prepare them for war. There were times when it would be sounded, praise God, for them to charge and attack the enemy. Praise the Lord. Somebody want to praise God. Somebody want to praise God. Somebody want to praise God right now. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Jesus. Somebody want to praise God. Somebody want to praise Him. Yeah, you need to praise God. You need to send up your praises. You need to send up your praises. The devil thought that he was going to lock you down, that you would never praise God again. But I hear a shout somewhere. There is a peculiar sound. Praise God. There is a sound in a bedroom. There is a sound on a pillow. There is a sound echoing somewhere. And one of these days, there's going to be a different sound. Praise the Lord. Praise God. I want to share with you, praise the Lord. I want to share with you from 1 Thessalonians 4, praise God, 13, praise God, to 17. Can someone just post that? 1 Thessalonians 4, verses 13 to 17, praise God. As a matter of fact, praise God, to 18. 1 Thessalonians 4. Praise the Lord. 1 Thessalonians 4, verses 13, praise God, to verses 18. Glory be to God. And the word of God says, praise the Lord. We're going to keep praising God in the word as we get, praise God, the word, praise God. But I would not have you ignorant. And the word of God is talking to the church. The word is talking to the body of Christ. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Here we see Paul says, but I would not have you ignorant. Praise God, brethren. Praise God, brethren. Glory be to God. Thank you, Tom. You got to work with me, my brother. Praise the Lord. For those of you that are just coming on, Brother Tom Davis, praise God. He used to be in the New Age movement. Praise the Lord. He used to be in the New Age movement, and God delivered him this year, March, out of that bondage, out of that cult. Praise the Lord. And now he's spreading the gospel. Now he is telling people about Jesus. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. First Thessalonians 4. Praise God. Hallelujah. But I would not have you ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep. Praise God, which are asleep. Here we see, praise God, that persons who have died in Christ, persons who family members, your parents, your siblings, praise the Lord, who have died, whether it's years ago, whether it was your grandmother, great-grandmother, aunt, a brother, a sister, a niece, a nephew, a child, a good friend, but they were Christians, they were saved, praise God, they were saved. They are sleeping in Christ, praise the Lord, hallelujah, glory be to God. He said, concerning them which are asleep, that ye sorrow not. We know it's natural to mourn on the death, on the death of a loved one. We know it's natural to mourn, but we know it's also, praise God, it's also another thing, praise God, for those of us who know the word of God, for those of us that know the word of God, We know what it is, praise God, to trust God and that they're not dead. They're not dead. Their body might be dead, but their spirit, their soul has been saved. Praise the Lord. He said that you sorrow not even as others which have no hope. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Even as others do, like sinners, like those that have no hope. We have a lively hope. Praise the Lord. We have a lively hope in Christ Jesus. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. For if we believe, you're talking to the body of Christ, for Christians, praise God. I don't care what's the name of your church. I don't care what denomination it is. Because if there was ever one thing that has caused so much division in the body of Christ, it's the thing about denomination. It's all this thing about denomination. There is but one church, one true church. And that's the true church of God, not a church that is just registered with a company, not an organization. But we're talking about those who have accepted Jesus Christ, those who are born again. Praise God. And if you are born again, praise the Lord. If you are born again and you're trusting Jesus, you have been washed in the blood of the Lamb. You are a part of this church. I want to make that clear. Praise God. Hallelujah. Because there is just too much confusion and division over who is right and who is wrong and who is saved and who is not saved. There is but one church. And God knows those that are His. Praise God. Not those that make the most noise on social media. Not those that shout the loudest. Not those that look the most holiest and all that kind of thing. God knows those that are His. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. If you love the word, just praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. And so praise God. Here we see, praise God, in verse 14 of 1 Thessalonians 4. It says, For if, that's if you believe. There's a lot of people don't believe in the rapture. There's a lot of people, you know why? If people had believed in the rapture more, we would have been preaching about the rapture and the return of Jesus Christ more than we're preaching about prosperity and about blessings and about get rich and about who's going to get a car and a house. We would be telling people and warning people, praise God, about the imminent return of Jesus Christ. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Now, I know that this might not be popular, and you might find that a lot of folks don't like this kind of thing. They like the hype. They like all the music. They like all the nice, sweet things that will cause them, their flesh to be ticklish. But I tell you, there are some folks, praise God, that are hungry for this kind of thing. The Lord spoke to me. And you know what the voice of God is saying in this hour. We must not underestimate our hearers. We must not underestimate our hearers. Sometimes people might think that people don't want to hear it, but the Holy Spirit is saying that people want to hear it. Can somebody praise the Lord? People want to hear the truth. People wants to hear the truth. People are fed up of all of the hype stuff. People are fed up. There are some folks that are backsliders. There are some folks that were raised and reared in Christian homes. And they know authentic gospel when they hear it. They know the truth when they hear it. You can polish it up. You can fix it up. You can change it. You can make it sound good. You can do all you want, not to offend, not to do this and do that. But people are hungry for the real gospel, for the truth. And I am determined, praise God, to bring the truth and nothing else but the truth. Praise the Lord. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody, and praise the Lord. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In 1 Thessalonians 4, for if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. Oh, glory be to God. If you believe, praise God, that Jesus, praise God, died, he was buried, but on the third day, he arose triumphantly from the grave. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And before he left, to God. He left an assignment, praise God, with the church, and he gave the church, praise God, the keys to the kingdom. Glory be to God. And he ascended back on high, praise God. If you believe, praise God, that Jesus is seated at the right hand of Father God, making intercessions for you and I, praise God, you must believe, praise God, that one day he's coming back again for those who are his. Praise the Lord. Glory be to God. Somebody praise the Lord. Somebody praise the Lord. Somebody praise the Lord. Somebody praise the Lord. Somebody in here, help me praise the Lord. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. In verse 15 of 1 Thessalonians 4, it says, For this we say, praise God, it says, for this we say unto you, unto the church, praise the Lord, unto the church, glory be to God, for this we say unto you, by the word of the Lord. People are tired of hearing man's word. People are fed up and tired of hearing your word and his word and her word. I am coming with the word of God. I am coming with the unchangeable, infallible, all-powerful word of God. Hallelujah. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive, glory be to God, talking about the rapture. I'm talking about the rapture. The return of Jesus Christ is imminent, my friends. Whether you believe it or not, the return of Jesus is imminent. Jesus is coming again. There will be a rapture. Whether people want to preach it or don't preach it, it won't stop the rapture. Whether people accept it or reject it, it won't stop the rapture. Whether people believe it or don't believe it, it won't stop the rapture. The rapture is going to take place, and it could happen anytime now. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive means, praise God, you're not just alive physically, but you are alive spiritually. Praise God. Hallelujah. For if any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. He has been recreated. He has been changed. He has been transformed. Praise God. Hallelujah. And he has received the new birth. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And it says for that we, all of us, no matter the denomination, no matter what the church name, praise God, all of us who are calling on the name of Jesus in spirit and in truth, all of us, praise God, who are waiting on the return of the Lord, we which are alive and remain, it's one thing to get saved. It's one thing to get saved, but it's another thing to stay saved. Praise God. Hallelujah. Don't let anyone fool you. Praise God. When you get saved and you accept Jesus, you must work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. Praise God. When I say work out, I don't mean you must work for your salvation. You have already received salvation, the free gift of salvation. Praise the Lord. You are saved. You are born again. But the enemy of man's soul, the devil, will always be around trying to tempt you, trying to get you back, trying to put you back in bondage and enslaved. You again. Hallelujah. You have been liberated. Praise the Lord. For we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. So you must remain until the coming of the Lord. You must hold on. Praise God. Though your anchor may be broken, your sails may be broken, your anchor is lost and destroyed, you must ride out your storm. You must hold on to Jesus. Praise the Lord. You can't allow the things of this world, the cares of this world, praise God, to cause you to lose out and miss heaven, your home, as your home. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. In verse 16 of 1 Thessalonians 4, it says, for the Lord himself. He's not sending Gabriel. He's not sending Michael. Praise God. He's not sending any of the archangels to come and receive us. Praise God. Jesus is coming back himself. Oh, I wish that I had some praises in here. Jesus is coming back himself for us. What a glorious time that will be. Glory be to God. What a glorious day that will be, or morning, noon, or night that will be, when Jesus put in his appearance. You know, all of the struggles, all of the things that we are going through now. Oh, glory to God. All of these pains, all of the sickness. Oh, glory to God. All of the disappointments. All of these lies they tell on us. All of the things that they try to do to harm us. All of these things. All of the heartbreaks and all of the mistakes and all of these things will be done away with when Jesus puts in his appearance. Praise God. Hallelujah. Yes, my friend, one day there will be a rapture. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Yes, my friend, for this, you know, in verse 16 of 1 Thessalonians 4, say, For the Lord himself shall descend. He ascended into heaven. Praise God, and he shall descend. He went up. And he's coming down. He's coming back again. Praise the Lord. For the Lord himself, that's what encourages me. The Lord Jesus himself, the one that I'm worshiping, the one that I'm spreading this gospel about, the one, praise God, that still heals the sick. Praise God. The one, praise God, hallelujah, that still opens blind eyes. The one, praise God, that still opens deaf ear. Oh, somebody, I feel the anointing in this place. Praise the Lord. Praise God. The one, praise God, that still provides. The one that still protects. Praise God. And the one, praise God, that is still has the power to save. Praise God. Hallelujah. I'm talking about the man called Jesus. I'm not talking about no human being. I'm not talking about no man or woman that can fail us. Jesus never fail. This same Jesus that I'm talking about, this same Jesus that you're praising, this same Jesus that you're saying hallelujah to, this same Jesus that you feel cold chills going, goosebumps going through your body right now, this is the Jesus that I'm talking about. The Jesus that is alive and well, making intercessions for you and I. Oh, glory to God. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. He said, praise God, the Lord himself shall descend from heaven. Praise God. That's where he's coming from. Contrary to what some might say, Jesus is not in the grave. Praise God. Jesus ascended when he came, praise God. When he came to this earth, he came, praise God, as a man to redeem man back onto himself. But he was full of God and full of man. Praise God. Hallelujah. He said, no man takes my life. I lay it down myself. Praise God. And I have the power to take it back up. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. God bless you, Bishop Ivor Carpenter, out there in Orlando. God bless you all. Praise the Lord. Not only that, praise God. But notice he said, when he's coming, praise the Lord. When he's coming with a shout, with the voice, praise God, of archangel, and with the trumpet of God. Hallelujah. Yes, my friend. Yes, my friend. He's coming. He's coming. Jesus is coming. He's coming back again. Jesus is coming one day. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. There's going to be a shout. There's going to be a shout. The trump of God is going to sound. Praise God. The trump of God is going to sound. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Somebody want to praise him. Somebody want to praise him. Jesus. Hey. Hey, Jesus. Yes. Glory to God. God bless you, Doc. Oh, Jesus. Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready? If the trump of God should sound tonight, this morning, this afternoon, today, wherever you are you ready, sir? Are you ready, madam? Are you ready? Are you ready, brethren? Jesus is coming again. Jesus is coming. Glory! Glory! Hallelujah! Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Oh, glory to God. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Can we take a praise break? Every one of you, just start tapping. Just take a praise break. Every one of you, just take a praise break. Take a praise break. Let us praise the Lord. Let us praise the Lord. Let us praise the Lord. Let us take a praise break. Oh, somebody take a praise break. That's right. Just praise Him, praise Him, praise Him. Just say, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, that I'm saved. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. We love you, Lord. 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 We love you. We love you. We love you. I love you, Lord. I love you. I love you. I love you. I love you. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 For the Lord Himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God. And the dead in Christ, the dead in Christ, the dead in Christ, those that have died in Christ, those that were saved, those that were Christians. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Thank you, Lord. Oh, I praise you, Almighty God. I glorify you. I praise you. Hallelujah. Guys, if there was ever a time that you need sound biblical doctrines, you need the Word of God, the solid food. Praise the Lord. I know it's one thing to enjoy the milk. It's one thing to enjoy the sugar-coated stuff. But there comes a time in your life, in my life, praise God, where we want the solid food, praise God, where we want that solidness to remind us, praise God, to bring us back to the old landmark, praise the Lord, hallelujah, glory be to God, hallelujah, yes, my friend, the trump of God and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Can you imagine those that have died in Christ? They're going to come, praise the Lord. They're going to come up out of the grave. Hallelujah. Yes, my friend, they're going to rise up out of that grave. No grave can hold the body down. Praise God. Those that have died in Christ. Ain't no grave can hold my body down. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Yes, they shall arise first. And watch this. Then, after they all have arrived, has risen from the grave, those of us who are alive and remain alive shall be caught up together to meet the Lord in the air. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. Whether they were cremated, it doesn't matter. Oh, once they died in Christ, praise God, they're going to come up. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. They're going to come up. Praise the Lord, from the grave. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Then we which are alive and remain, praise God. Hallelujah. Shall be caught up. We shall be caught up. Some people say, oh, the word rapture is not in the Bible. There are so many words that is not in the Bible. But we know, praise God, we shall be caught up. We shall be caught up together with them. Praise God, to be caught up, we shall be snatched away quickly. Praise God, hallelujah. And we shall be caught up together with them in the clouds, in the air. Praise God, to meet the Lord. And so shall we ever be with the Lord. Praise God. I don't know about you, my friend, but a day is coming. Praise the Lord. A day is coming when we are going to be caught up if we hold on. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. First of all, I want to make it clear before I come down. I want to leave you with these words so that you understand about the rapture a little better. Praise the Lord. The purpose for the rapture, the main purpose for the rapture, brothers and sisters, ladies and gentlemen, is to receive the saints to himself as he promised. For the Lord Jesus himself shall descend. Praise God. He said, I'm going to prepare you a place that where I am, you will be also. He's coming back again, brothers and sisters. This should cause you to want to rejoice. This should cause you to want to praise God. This should cause you to want to get in the Word of God more. Read your Bible more. Praise God more. Commit yourself, praise God, to God. Dedicate yourself to the Lord. Get out on the highways and the byways. There are too many folks, praise God, that have a title and they don't want to evangelize. They think it's too, they think themselves too good to get out on the highways and byways, to get out by supermarkets, to get out on the streets and hand out tracts and tell someone about the love of God. They think that it's all about a microphone and four walls and air conditions and lovely music and feeling good. That's what they call preaching of the gospel. But you're not preaching the gospel if you're ashamed of the gospel. You can't be ashamed of the gospel. God, Jesus said, if you're ashamed to confess me before men, then I'll be ashamed to confess you before my Father. Praise the Lord. And so if there was ever a time that we need to evangelize, that we need to get out there and tell lost sinners about the love of God and the imminent return of Jesus Christ, it is now. Come out of the four walls. Come out of your comfort zones. Come out of the padded pews. Come out of all of the lights and the glitz and the glamour. And get out on the highways and the byways. And tell somebody Jesus loves you. Tell somebody Jesus loves you. He saved a wretched sinner like me. And he can save you. There are sinners. There are men and women that will never put their foot in a building. There are men and women that would never put their foot, in a church. And so there are some of us that we must rise up and become walking epistles. We must rise up and become walking pages, a walking Bible. Let people hear your story. Let people know, praise God, where God brought you from. Praise God. Let somebody know. Praise God. It's not about the shiny shoes and the Gucci bags and the lovely hairstyles and all the fancy dresses and all these things and all that makes everybody just look so sharp and nice. Jesus is coming again. Praise God. Hallelujah. Jesus is coming again. Every opportunity I get, I want to tell somebody that Jesus is coming again. Hallelujah. Stop playing church. This ain't no time to play with God. This ain't no time to play church. One foot in and one foot out. This ain't no time to bring down mockery on the church. Praise God. If you're saved, stay saved. Live saved. Walk saved. Talk saved. Live the life that sinners can see. Praise God. Hallelujah. Don't let people on social media have to be passing remarks against you. Praise God. Because you're only preaching up a storm. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Get out on the highways and byways. Tell somebody about the love of God. Come out of the four walls. Put down the microphone. Hand out tracts. Put on your sneakers. Put on your sandals. Put on your walking shoes. Shod your feet with the preparation of the gospel. And get out on the highways and tell somebody about the love of God. God is not going to reward you for just being behind four walls. God is not going to reward you for just preaching, praise God, and just talking to the same two or three every day when you don't want to get out there and tell somebody else about the love of God. Every opportunity that I get, every time I can go out in the field, I will go out in the field, praise the Lord, and tell somebody about the love of God. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Don't be caught up in titles. Don't be caught up in all the titles and all that. If you're having the title, let the title speak for itself by the works that you do. Jesus said, the works that I do speaks for me. Praise the Lord. The works that I do speak for me. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Don't be ashamed to evangelize. Fall in love with evangelism. Jesus never had a building. Praise God. He never had a building. Whenever he went into the synagogue, he only went in and he read from the prophet Isaiah. And he closed the books and he went back out on the highways and the byways. And we must be followers of Jesus Christ. Oh, I wish I had some help in here. I wish I had some help in here. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God. Why am I saying this? Why am I saying this? Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost. Oh, glory, oh, glory. Oh, glory. Hallelujah. We got sick folks in hospital beds still talking about the love of God. God bless you, Pastor Charmin. God bless you, Pastor. Praise God. Deliverous. God bless you, girl. Praise God. Hallelujah. God bless all of you. Praise God. God bless those of you. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. This is not the time to be worrying about all these fancy titles. Praise the Lord. There seems to be only two titles that men and women are interested in. Prophet and apostle. Everybody wants to be apostle. Everybody wants to be prophet, but they don't want to do the work of the prophet. They don't want to do the work of the apostle. They don't want to do the work of an evangelist. They don't want to do the work of a pastor. Praise God, of a teacher. Praise God. Hallelujah. They don't want to have no part with the helps ministry, the auxiliaries, the prayer band. Praise God. Nobody want to lock in anymore and pray. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. Everybody wants to look nice and glamorous and all this. Well, I'm telling you one thing. If it's nice and glitz and glamour that you're looking from this woman of God, you're not going to get it. Praise the Lord. Because I know what God has commanded me and commissioned me to do. Praise the Lord. And I'm going out on the highways and byways. Time is running out. The clock is ticking. Praise the Lord. The clock is ticking. Jesus is about to put in his appearance as I'm talking about the rapture. Praise the Lord. The return of Jesus is imminent. He is coming back again. Get out on the highways. Come out of the four walls. Praise God. Come out of the four walls. Tell somebody that about the love of God. They might not come to church when you invite them, but one of these days you might be preaching somewhere. And when you look, there comes that man. There comes that woman. It has happened to me in our ministry on many occasions. We have gone out and we have had open air meetings. Nobody gets saved. Nobody surrendered. But I prayed and I prophesied and I spoke a word and I spoke life. Praise God. And when you look, praise God, people start coming into the church. They said, I remember the day you prayed for me. Praise God. Hallelujah. I remember the day that you prayed for me, woman of God. I didn't come right away, but I remember those words. Praise the Lord. Get out on the highways and byways. God bless you, Minister Denise Myers. God bless you. God bless you all. Hallelujah. 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 May God help us if we think it's just about our comfort zones. May God help us if we think it's just about four walls. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. I believe the day is coming, praise God, when the church is going to come under so much opposition. Just the other day, praise God, August the 7th, 2018, praise God, over 8,000 churches were locked down, many demolished in Rwanda, Africa. Praise God. Many of them were demolished and locked down for preaching the prosperity gospel only. Their main focus was on prosperity, prosperity, prosperity. Get rich, get rich. Gimme, 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 gimme. Praise the Lord. What about the rapture? What about holiness? What about soul salvation? What about repentance? What about sanctification? What about holiness unto the Lord? Oh, we say we don't want to offend. We don't want to offend nobody. Well, I stop by to let you know, Jesus didn't come to please men. He didn't come, praise God, to please men. Praise God, he came to save man and to redeem man back unto himself. I pray and trust that you have been wonderfully blessed. Praise the Lord. I want you to know, don't get me wrong. Praise God. Hallelujah. Don't get me wrong. Praise God. Hallelujah. 3 John 2 speaks about, I wish above all things that you prosper and be in good health, even as your soul prospers. The Bible didn't just leave it there and say, I wish above all things that you prosper. The Bible said, I wish above all things that you would prosper and be in good health. But it depends on the condition of your soul, even as your soul prospers. So the more that you prosper in the things of God, The more you prosper in the word of God, is the more prosperous you would become in all things. But today we don't hear that. We hear that in 24 hours you're going to get rich. In 24 hours you're going to get this and you're going to get that. All of these things. But we brought nothing into this world, brothers and sisters, ladies and gentlemen. And we surely can take nothing out of this world. Praise the Lord. I don't come here to promise you silver and gold. Praise God. But I tell you about Jesus. And I want you to know that Jesus is about to put in his appearance. He's about to return anytime now. And every opportunity you get as a pastor, as an evangelist, as a prophet, as an apostle, as a teacher of the gospel, as a preacher, as a brother, as a sister. Yes, my brother, praise God. Push those scriptures out there. Praise the Lord. We are in this together. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm not about heresies. I'm not about all of these beggar elements. I ain't coming here to talk about days. I ain't come here to tell you that if you wear a pants, or if you have on an earring, or if you cream your hair, or if you're this or you're that. I come to tell you that Jesus is coming back again. Get your house in order. Get ready for the return of Jesus Christ. He's coming back again. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Liz. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Yes, my friend. Glory be to God. Whenever I open a mic, whenever I hold a mic, I act as if it's my last time holding a microphone. I act as if it's my last day, my last hour. No man knows the day nor the hour. Do you know the day or the hour when the death angel will knock on your door? Do you know when Jesus will return? No man knows the day nor the hour. Jesus is coming back to receive his saints unto himself. Praise the Lord. Also to resurrect the dead in Christ from amongst the wicked dead. This is the reason for the rapture. First of all, he's coming back to receive his own, his people, his saints unto himself. And another thing, praise God, to resurrect the dead in Christ from, hallelujah, from amongst the wicked dead. Praise God, for judgment day is coming when every man will have to stand before God and give an account for himself for all that he have done. So for those of you that have an opportunity to live this life and spread this gospel, and you're playing around with it, you're acting as if you have control of the gospel, you're acting as if you preach only where you want to preach and teach where you want to preach and teach, I want you to know this gospel has been embedded, praise God, and entrusted to each and every one of us. And we must get out on the highways and the byways and win the loss at any cost. God is going to hold each and every one of us accountable for what we do with the gospel. Praise the Lord. So he's coming to receive the saints. We're talking about the rapture. He's coming to resurrect the dead in Christ from amongst the evil, wicked dead. Praise God. He's coming to take the saints to heaven to live in the new Jerusalem. Praise God. I'm going to be back with another part. Praise God. As we talk about the great marriage supper, we're going to be looking at the great tribulation. We're going to be looking at the you know, different things as it pertains to end time prophecy. Keep on looking out. Praise the Lord. Because I'm coming back with some strong teaching. Praise the Lord. I'm coming back with the word. I'm not coming with no milk. I'm not coming with no crushed potato or no crushed pumpkin. I'm coming with the word of God. Praise God. Hallelujah. People are tired. God said to me, he said, I must not estimate the listener, underestimate and undermine you people out there. God said, I'm not to undermine any of you, whether you're on YouTube, WhatsApp, Facebook, Instagram. God said, cherish what I've entrusted you with. Cherish it. I've entrusted you with hidden treasures. Cherish it, saith the Lord. And I don't undermine any one of you. And I don't underestimate any of you, my listeners. Praise God, my brothers and sisters. I do believe in my heart that you are hungry, that you are thirsty. Praise God for solid food. You are tired of the milk. You are tired of the prosperity gospel. You are tired of all the hurry come up, quick fix, microwave stuff that we see out there. You are tired of it. You're hungry. Your souls are indicting a good matter. Praise the Lord. Somebody want to praise God. Your souls are indicting a good matter. Your mind is on Jesus. You are now turning around. You are now reflecting. Praise God on how it was when you gave your heart to God. How you felt when you gave your heart to God. Oh, glory to God. Let nobody cause you to lose your salvation. Let no man, no woman, nobody, no child, oh, no husband, no wife. Praise God, no brother, no sister, no colleague. Let no one steal your joy. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, Jesus, I know you're coming again. Ah, glory to God, glory to God. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God. Somebody worship, somebody worship, somebody worship. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Glory to God, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Not only is he coming to take the saints to heaven to live in the New Jerusalem and receive their rewards, praise God, but one of the reasons for the rapture, praise God, hallelujah, is to change the bodies of the saints into immortality. We shall be changed. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. We shall be changed. Praise God. These clothes ain't going nowhere. Praise God. This old flesh ain't going nowhere. Praise the Lord. We shall be changed in a moment, in a twinkling of an eye. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. All these troubles, all these trials will be over. Praise God. All the lies. Hallelujah. All the fakeness and all the pretense will be over. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. So first of all, I want to leave you with 10 things, and these are the 10 things, praise God. These are the reasons, these are the 10 main reasons for the rapture. These are the 10 main reasons why Jesus said, I am coming back myself to receive you unto myself. These are the 10 main reasons to receive the saints to himself as promised, to resurrect the dead in Christ from amongst the evil dead, to take saints to heaven to live in the New Jerusalem and receive their rewards. Praise God, to change the bodies of the saints into immortality, to present saints before Father God. Hallelujah. To present us before Father God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. To make saints whole in body, soul, and spirit. Glory be to God. Talking about the reason for the rapture. Praise the Lord. To receive the fruit of the early and latter rain. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory. What a glorious day that will be. To cause the saints to escape the tribulation. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. We know, praise God, that the promise will be made. Praise God. There's going to rise the Antichrist. And we know, praise God, that he's going to promise world peace. We are now in the new world order. We are now, right now, in the new world order. When we look around and see all the biometrics, when we see all the finger scanning, when we see all of these things, I'm going to come back and teach you some stuff. I'm very, very knowledgeable about some things that a lot of pastors don't even know about. Praise God. I've been studying these things for many, many years. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. When it comes to end time prophecy, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And so Jesus is coming back, praise God, to remove the hinder of lawlessness, praise God. He's coming back to permit, praise God, the revelation of the Antichrist, praise God. Hallelujah. So I just want you to know, you don't want to be left behind. You don't want to be left behind and have to go through the great tribulation. Praise the Lord. You can't guarantee, praise God, as a Gentile, that you'll make it through the great tribulation. We know that many of the Jews who rejected Jesus Christ, praise God, and who are still rejecting him, we know that if they have not accepted after Jesus, that during the great tribulation, that many will be slain, many will be killed. Come on, somebody. But many will receive them as their Messiah. Glory be to God. But I don't know about you, but I don't want to be left behind. I want to be caught up, praise God, in the rapture. I want to be caught up, praise God. I want to be caught up. Remember, praise God, that when Jesus comes in the rapture, he's not coming to earth. Praise God. He's coming for the saints. Praise God. He's coming for the saints. And when he returns again, he's coming with the saints. What a glorious time that will be. He's coming for the believers. But when he comes back to judge the world, then we will be coming back with him to judge the world. My God, tell me if you don't want to live this life. Tell me if you don't want to praise God. Tell me if you don't want to share with your friends and loved ones. Tell me if you don't want to tell somebody about the love of God. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. I pray and trust that you have been wonderfully blessed. Praise the Lord by these few words. Glory be to God. I pray that you have been blessed. Start leaving your comments. If you have been blessed, leave your comments. If you want me to pray with you, leave your comments now as I'm getting ready to close down. Hallelujah. I feel the anointing. I feel the presence of the Lord. It's as if a host of angels is right here with me, and they're there with you also.
Only you can do what no man can do. Only you can say what no man can say.
Help me, Jesus. Pray with you. Praise the Lord. Go ahead. Just ask. Praise God. Ask. Praise the Lord. I'm willing to pray for whosoever will ask. Praise the Lord. Prayer is something that I never turn down. Praise God. I never. I'm always asking the brethren at our church to pray. Pray for us. Pray for us. Praise God. Asking our leaders to pray for us. Praise the Lord. Pray for us. Pray for me and Bishop Leroy. Pray for our family. Pray for our children. Praise the Lord. Praise God. Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
You are doing the same today.
In my spirit that I want to pray for somebody. Who is it? Praise God. I feel led in my spirit that I want to pray for somebody. Praise God. You have been feeling down. You've been feeling low over the last couple of weeks. You've just been feeling so discouraged. You know, but I believe that you have been uplifted in your spirit. You have been encouraged. Praise the Lord. Allow me to pray for you. Just ask. Allow me to pray for you. Hallelujah. Allow the Holy Spirit to move. Allow the Holy Spirit to move. Allow the Holy Spirit to move.
Jesus,
times, praise God. We're praying and we're asking God to do things for us, praise God. Help us to be sensitive in the spirit when God is moving, when God is speaking, praise God. Help us to never question God's doing, praise God. There's times we don't understand things. There's times that we want to understand everything, but if God had to show us everything, then some of us wouldn't be able to handle it. We would drop dead with heart attack if God had to show us everything. So whenever God is doing something on your behalf, even when you don't understand, even when it doesn't feel good, you still want to take a moment and lift up your hands and say, Father God, I don't understand, but I thank you. I thank you, Father God. I praise you. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God.
I'm staying right here, and I'm gonna wait for my change, because I won't complain. I'm gonna praise His name, for I know He's able to see me through. So
I'm waiting, still waiting.
God bless you. God bless you, Sir Sherman Williams. God bless you, sir. Hold the faith. Hold the faith. Hold the faith. I'm waiting. Yes, Pastor Charmaine. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Tiffany, God bless you, darling. God bless you, Carmen Hoyt. Praise God. Yes. Delavere, Pastor Delavere, God bless you. Praise the Lord. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you, Sonia Blake. God bless you. God bless you all. Praise God. I'm getting ready to come down. God bless you. I want to pray for 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 you. Hallelujah.
Waiting for someone just to put him in.
Glory to God.
He never gave up. He just lay right there. One day his breakthrough came when Jesus passed his face.
What it is you're waiting on, praise God. What it is you're waiting on. Yes, you're waiting on God to answer that prayer. You're waiting on God to work that thing out for you. You're waiting on God to deliver you, to set you free. You're waiting, you're waiting, you're waiting. Your breakthrough is about to come. Praise God. Hallelujah. Your breakthrough is on the way. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Oh, I just want to take it back from the top. Praise God. Hallelujah. Somebody's waiting for something. And unless God does it, it just can't be done. Unless God do it for you, it just can't be done. Hallelujah. Start praising Him in your bedroom. Start praising Him in your kitchens, in your cars, on the workplace, in an infirmary somewhere. Hallelujah. At a fire station, a police station, an airport, on the train, on the bus, in a taxi, in a supermarket, wherever you are. At a mechanic shop, barber shop. Yeah, salon. Oh my God. Hallelujah. Praise God. You're sitting there by yourself waiting. Yeah. It's going to happen for you, my friend. It's going to happen.
I'm going to wait for my change. I won't complain. I'm going to praise His name. For I know He's able.
Lord, I know I'm waiting.
sometimes. Praise God. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Yes, Pastor Charmaine. God bless you. Tatiana. Praise the Lord. Sometimes when we're praying, you know, we get so impatient, you know, because things ain't working as fast as we want it to work. Even sometimes, you know, it seems as if it's working, it's going through, and then all of a sudden you get this disappointing news. But I hear the Spirit of the Lord says to continue to wait. Wait on God. And when we say wait, praise God, like a waitress, like a waiter and a waitress you serve. When you're waiting on someone at a restaurant, they're standing there patiently waiting on you. Praise God. And so while you're waiting, serve God. Give Him your best. Give God your very, very best. Praise God. Give Him your all. You have come too far to turn back now, my friend. You can't afford to do that. Praise God. Through many danger, toils, and snares, you have already come. Praise God. Praise God.
And it won't be long.
Church,
waiting.
I'm waiting.
Still waiting.
For my breakthrough.
You told me to wait.
Lord,
I know.
I'm
waiting.
So I'm waiting.
Still waiting.
Still waiting.
You told me to wait.
Praise the Lord. I'm so glad for all of you that have enjoyed the teachings that I did. Praise God. All the way in UK, Canada, Barbados, Trinidad, Cayman Islands, Jamaica, United States. Praise God. All over. I don't even know where some of you are. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. But I'm so glad that you enjoyed that teaching I just did on the rapture. For those of you that are coming on a little late, praise God, you can take it from the top. It was awesome. It is awesome. The rapture. Praise God. We're talking about the return of Jesus Christ. Something that is hardly spoken of, hardly preached of, hardly talked about in the old days. This is what we were fed on. End time prophecy. Even though some of those preachers way back then, some of them didn't have degrees. Some of them didn't have titles. They couldn't read and write, but they knew the word of God. And they would bring the word of God with clarity, with power, and with the anointing. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory be to God.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. You're healed. If there's any of you not feeling well in your body right now, praise the Lord. I pray and trust that you'll be healed in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Touch your body. Touch your knees. Touch your heart. Touch your head. Touch your back, your hips. Touch your reproductive organs, your tummy, your stomach. Touch whatever part of it. Yes. Hallelujah.
And when it seems hope has gone away, by faith, you melt and pray, knowing Jesus will be passing your way.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
You are healed. Your faith is made. You hold.
Jesus.
You are healed. The fountain,
hallelujah,
is no more.
Jesus.
No more.
Glory to God.
Virtue has left his body. No more time to cry and worry. Praise the Lord.
I know you're here.
Now tell the world what the Lord has done. How he has touched you with his mighty hand. And from that day, you have been set free.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
The doctors can't believe the result. Say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Jump and shout. Praise the Lord. I know you're here. Oh.
You are here.
Yes, yes.
Your faith is made.
here today. Many of you right now, you're sitting in the hospital. You may be sitting at home when you're sick there, wondering where is God in my sickness. But I've got news to you today. I'm here to proclaim a miracle, because I know that God is taking the lead in business. Right now, I'm going to reach out my faith and claim your miracle. Claim your healing right now, because Jesus is passing your way. Come on, my brother. Come on. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
I know you're here.
Oh,
you are here. Your faith is made. You hold.
Praise God. I don't care what it is that the enemy has put on you. Praise the Lord. High blood pressure have to go. Praise God. Diabetes have to go. High cholesterol have to go. Heart murmuring, circulatory problems, clots. Come on. Our problems in the pregnancy have to go in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Migraine headaches, tension headaches. Come on, panic attacks in the name of Jesus. Speak to your body right now and declare, I am healed. In the name of Jesus, tell yourself, I don't have any heart problem. I don't have any diabetes. I don't have no high blood pressure. Even though you're taking the medication, even though you're going through what you're going through, decree and declare over your body that you are healed right now. In the name of Jesus, whatever it is, we come against cancer. We come against cancer. We come against leukemia. We come against every ailment, every false report, every false diagnosis. We plead the blood of Jesus against it. Hey! I plead the blood and I release the fire of God, that the fire of God may touch your body and burn out everything that is not of God. We come against the spirit of witchcraft. We come against the spirit of necromancy. We come against the spirit of candle burning and dream readers and watchers. We come against it in the name of Jesus. Oh, glory to God. I plead the blood over you, over your family, over your house, your finances, over your business, your ministry. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Did you stop to pray? Did you stop to pray? And if you didn't remember to pray, pray now. In the name of Jesus, I want to pray for you. 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 I want to pray for you.
Did you ask the Lord to guide you as you started on to your day?
Whatever it is, if I didn't call it by name, post it, release it. Come on, in the name of Jesus, declare it. Come on, somebody just say, you're healed, that they are healed from eye disease. In the name of Jesus, whatever it is, offline, online, whatever it is, put it out. Let the devil know, in the name of Jesus, I'm not claiming any sickness. I'm not claiming any swelling. I'm not claiming any pain. I'm not claiming it in the name of Jesus. I shall not die on medications. I shall not die in sickness. I am going to decree and declare, for healing is the children's bread, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, I believe in miracles. Is there anybody else that believe in miracles? Claim your miracle right now.
Jesus is coming.
Hey!
Again.
Yes, arthritis have to go.
In his words.
In the name of Jesus. Negative thoughts have to go.
He will come.
It's time you call it by name. Time you call it by name. Some of you, that's why you're not getting your deliverance and your healing, because you don't want to call it by name. Call that thing by name. Let the devil know enough is enough. Serve notice.
This morning.
Glory be to God. Sister Winnie, Praise God, Evangelist Winnie. I called out blood clots in the name of Jesus. Yes, yes, yes. The Lord had revealed it to me that someone was on with blood clots. Come on, high blood pressure have to go. Crohn's disease have to go. That's right, in the name of Jesus. We come against ulcerative colitis. Your colon, praise God. I am a colon care specialist, so I know exactly what you're talking about, my brother. In the name of Jesus, I speak to your colon right now. I speak to that area right now. In the name of Jesus, I speak, praise God, to the ascendant colon, the transverse colon, the descendant colon. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. For those of you that didn't know, praise God, I am a board certified naturopathic practitioner, alternative medicine, and my specialty is colon care and detoxification. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. Going to be coming with some health segments. Praise the Lord. Healthy lifestyles. God is good to me, guys. God is good. Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. 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 Praise God. I'm going to be leaving you with this one. Praise the Lord. I pray that you have been wonderfully blessed. Until next time. Praise God. I enjoyed your company. Praise God. I enjoyed you very much. Praise the Lord. For those of you that are coming on offline, praise God. I just want to say welcome to the program. I want to welcome all of you new viewers. Remember, hit the notification button and follow me. Praise the Lord. Never you miss a segment. Never you miss a program here at Carib Cool Breeze. Don't forget, praise God, you can send me your messages. Praise the Lord. You can leave your comments. I want to pray with you on behalf of Bishop Leroy Fagan, the man himself, and all of us here at Vision Miracle Church of God Evangelistic Association. This includes Sanctuary of Love. Praise the Lord. They're going to be adding something to their name shortly. Praise the Lord. Bishop Ivy. Praise God. My mama. Praise God. My daughter Charmaine. Pastor Charmaine. Yeah, my son. Yeah, man. Pastor Demean Walters. Yes, Brother Sean. My son Terrell. And the girls and all the brethren. Yes, my other son, Pastor Terrence Brown. Sister Doreen Brown. They're doing a wonderful job out there in Hollywood, Florida. Also, praise the Lord. Praise God. Hallelujah. If you don't have a home-based church, Pastor Charmaine or Bishop, you can release their address. Praise God. They're in Hollywood, they're in Orlando. Praise God. God bless all of you. I love you with the love of God. Remember, Jesus is coming back again. Praise God. He's coming back again. Praise God. And I pray that you're ready for the rapture. Praise the Lord. I pray that you listen to this over and over again, and that you'll get it embedded in your spirit. Brother Tom out there in the UK, thank you, man. Thank you all the time. Big up yourself all the time. Congrats and welcome to the family of God. If you're recently saved and you're born again, welcome to the family of God. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Radio is one of my favorites. I've done radio for 14 years in the Cayman Islands. Yes, radio and television. Praise the Lord. And so, praise God, this is also one of my passions. Praise the Lord. I love you all with the love of God. So I'm going to switch this one, and I'm going to leave you with this beautiful one. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. I'm going to leave you with this lovely one. Send up your prayer requests, your testimonies. Until next time, this is your friend, your host. Yes, your hostess, that is. Apostle Dr. Juliet Fagan, same Bishop Juliet Fagan. Love you all. Ah, glory be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Leaving you with this one. Leaving you with this one. Leaving you with this one. Good night. Good morning. Good afternoon. Wherever you are. Stay good. Walk good. God bless. Until next time, peace and love, which means shalom.
That shall make me more like thee. I am praying, blessed Savior, to be more and more like thee. I am praying that thy spirit, like a dove, may rest on me. Thou who knowest all my weakness, thou who knowest all my care, while I teach precious promise, it will hear and answer prayer. I am praying, blessed Savior, for a faith so clear and bright, that I will see thy glory.